Took me way too long to figure that out. Next year, I'll be in the know.
Along these roads we roam, we find adventure through traveling, camping, boondocking, and exploring.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Vlogcast episode number 91. My name is Russ.
And I'm Carrie.
And we are the roads we roam. Well, we are still here at Escapade 2019, but this is the last day.
It is gorgeous here in Tucson. I think we're going to stay a couple extra days
because
this is the best weather we've had since we've hit the road in October.
Yeah, I mean, look at it. It's morning time. It's early in the morning here, and I don't have a jacket on.
Me neither.
Yeah, that's really impressive that you don't have a jacket on. But last night, we didn't even turn our heater on.
I know, our heater was probably like, thank you. Need the rest. But the winds have died down completely. Yesterday, I think it got up in the 80s.
Yeah, it was nice. We opened up all the windows on the little guy, Max. We had a beautiful cross breeze going in there. It was very comfortable.
That is when the little guy really, I just love it. Because that cross breeze, I heard other people running their AC at certain times, and we didn't have to at all. And it was just so comfortable.
Well, it's one of the main reasons we bought the little guy, Max. All those windows, I think there's 7 of them in there offhand.
For a little trailer, that's amazing.
Yeah, it's like all windows. So it's nice and comfortable in there.
Today, what we have to look forward to, there's a pet parade.
Yes.
And Russ just found out this morning it's a costume one. So I'm going to try to get big. You have a chihuahua, you have to dress it up. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Abby will not play that game. She's not interested in playing that game. But Billy has no choice. So Billy is going to be a... Should we give it away or just let it go until Saturday?
Let's hold off because I'm still trying to pull it together.
Okay.
I don't know if it'll work yet or
not.
Gotcha. There's also a chili cook-off.
I wonder, is there taste testing there?
Yeah.
Or do only the judges get to test?
Oh, I don't know. I'm hoping.
Yeah.
I'm planning. That's
my
right
goodness.
It's right at lunchtime, so I guess you've got to, and then everybody gets to put in their votes. That's what I think, because they also have a photo contest going on all this week where people just get to go through and just put their votes in a tin, and that seems to be the way that they run things, so I'm hoping, crossing my fingers with that one.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, if there are enough chili cookers, we won't even have to pay for lunch. We'll just go there and guise of taste testing and judging. We'll fill up on chili.
There we go. Closing ceremonies are today at 3, and then they're going to follow it by more food, a farewell fiesta.
I like the sound of that.
Yeah. Well, they're going to have a bunch of food vendors and stuff come in, and then people can all mill around and do your final socialization.
I like the sound of fiesta. I don't necessarily like the sound of farewell. It's going to be a sad day leaving.
Well, I think it's because we're just getting comfortable enough. I like the length of this event because it gives you enough time to really get to know your neighbors, get comfortable talking to people, and especially as a first timer, you don't have those circles yet, and sometimes you feel a little bit awkward working your way into a group. And the length of this program allows you to break down some of those barriers and actually get to know some people.
Yeah, you know, when we first got here, day one, we were like, wow, it seems kind of, you know, everybody has their own little special groups that they're already in. And that's kind of how it felt. I mean, we didn't feel excluded by any means, but it felt difficult to get into these groups. Well, I think the problem was more on our side. You just have to go and search yourself because they're very welcoming. But every single day you meet one or two more friends. And I mean, I'm not just talking acquaintances. I'm talking you make friendships out here. And so next year when we come, guess what?
We're going to know people.
We're going to have like 4 or 5 friends and a lot of acquaintances. And I think every year you just keep adding to that friend base.
Exactly.
So it becomes easier and easier. You know, Carrie also mentioned the thing a little bit earlier about we were new, we weren't aware what was going on. So there are a lot of things that we didn't know were available. You know, like one of the things is the Christian Fellowship every morning.
Every morning, I think it's at 7 a.m. People can get together for that. They also have Zumba and line dancing to get you going first thing in the morning.
Man, not my thing.
This is early enough. We can still go do that.
No, you know me. I have no rhythm and I move like a 2x4 in the wind.
Well, you could learn at your own pace in a safe environment. How about that?
Yeah, so there were a lot of seminars again yesterday. I know you went to one of them.
I went to the healthcare one. I went to a good portion of the healthcare one. And then we also did the Smart Way program.
Yep. So that's part one. And part one, again, like we said earlier, is you hook or you take your truck as you would travel. So we had to load carry, the dogs, and anything else that we usually travel with in the truck and take it over there and get it weighed. That was pretty quick. I was surprised. They allotted 2 hours to get everybody through. I was like, wow, that's not going to happen, because I saw the list when we signed up. There were a bunch of people. But we were in line for about 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And we got there right at 4 when it started. By 4:18, I think we were through. So it's a very quick process. If you're going to come here next year and you see that Smart Way thing and you see all the people signed up for it, don't fret, because it goes very quickly. They've got it streamlined.
Exactly. We also got to the Gold Prospecting Metal Detecting Club social.
Yep, they were one of the birds of a feather, which I'm definitely going to join. It was kind of neat because I got to blend work in on this trip throughout not work, and it wasn't even planned. Usually when I'm doing work, I've got it planned. I was like, okay, I've got to go to this event, I've got to meet with these people, or I've got to meet with this group of guys. This time we just stumbled on it, and the two aligned.
They did, and he gave away a fantastic prize to the club. So on behalf of Fisher,
yes,
they gave away an F-22 metal detector.
F-22 metal detector. That's a nice metal detector because it's an all-purpose weatherproof detector. You can hunt in the hardest rain, mud, whatever. You don't have to worry about it getting wet. And it'll do everything. It'll find gold. It'll find coins. It'll find relics. You name it, it'll do it.
Now, you may have remembered that yesterday we kind of listed several other seminars that we were going to go to.
Yeah.
And you're wondering, why did Carrie only go to part of the healthcare one?
Yeah.
Well, we had kind of put out there to everybody, hey, we're going to be here. Let us know if you're in town. Halfway through the healthcare session, we get a text. And who is it but?
Yeah, it's Ace and Amanda from Two Doves Nations. So, of course, we had to meet up with them.
Oh, yeah.
Healthcare is important, but our viewers and the people that we watch are more important than healthcare. Come on.
I was just so surprised that they actually made it, because they had communicated with us offline and said we might try to go. And then they said they couldn't make it. And then just suddenly, hey, guess what? We're here.
Yeah, so. They explained that to us. They were waiting on a package, an Amazon package. And Carrie and I know all too well that a lot of times your travel is based off of deliveries. That's the whole reason we went back to the TRC area again a week after we left it, because we had to wait on a package. So we totally get that. Some great people there, I think, with Ace and Amanda. We went over to the Escapers. They actually joined Escapees and Escapers, and we went over to an Escapers event and got to meet some other great people as well.
It felt really cool, because at first, and here's the story kind of with the beginning of the week, how we just felt uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. Every day around 4 o'clock, Escapers were gathering by the bleachers. It sounded, you know?
Yeah, so high school, you know, under the bleachers, guys.
But it was very strategically located, because RV Country every day offered us
this was brilliant. Yeah,
where they gave out free beer and wine. So the Escapers are smart enough to say, we're just going to piggyback right next to it. So on your way to the gathering, you pick up your beer and wine.
Right next to it at the same darn time. Took me way too long to figure that out. Next year, I'll be in the know so I can get my free beer and wine.
So we went to the Escapers little gathering during that time, and mm-hmm. we also met Kathy and Larry and Jim and Tracy. Jim and Tracy aren't full timing yet, but they're getting ready to. They live here in Tucson, so they've been in the area getting to meet everybody and just getting ready to do that big jump.
Yeah, it's interesting. It's kind of it's kind of like us, where one of us works from the road, and that would be Tracy is going to work from the road. She's going to keep her own job. She's going to be mobile. Jim is a multi-talented individual. You know, this guy can fix and make anything. So I don't know. They were talking about possibly getting a RV repair cert or something like that.
Oh, that would be so smart.
Man, I tell you. Yeah, yeah.
Because I've thought about that.
I'm going to follow them around because
there's no
issues.
Way we could qualify.
No, not us. No. I'm going to follow Jim around.
Yeah, that way if anything happens, so, you know, we're good to go and stuff. But we just met lots of great people.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's, I think, the biggest thing that Russ talked about earlier is just get out there and kind of insert yourself into those things, because we wound up hanging out for the remainder of the evening with these people. Mm-hmm. We even went to dinner with Ace and Amanda.
Yes.
Afterwards, we shut the place down.
We did. Yeah. How long has it been since we shut
the place
down? The place
closes at 8, but...
And what's sad is about an hour and 20 minutes later, I was racked out.
Yeah.
Woo, that was a long, crazy night.
Well, this was busy days for you. That's what it is. But we've had so much fun this week. I hope we're giving you guys a good enough idea of what type of things they offer at these events.
Yeah. And you know, I just wanted to clarify on that. Our vlogs here are not all inclusive. This is exactly what you're going to, this is what you're going to do. We want to give you the feel. We want to give you a little bit of knowledge so you understand what's available, what might be available, the feel of it. We've got a couple of comments that said we weren't giving enough information, and I get that, and they were never designed for that. So we apologize up front, but we hope what we're giving you is valuable, and we hope, and we think it is, and we think you, if you come here blind, you've never been here before, we think you're gonna be able to use these videos and your experience is gonna be enhanced.
In conjunction with our Saturday video.
Yes.
Saturday will actually be taking you throughout the event and you get to see the locations.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why that can't go out every day is it takes a while to pull those videos together. But we wanted to take you along with this one this week. It was just so important. But also, if there's a specific question you have about it, please don't hesitate. Put it below and we'll make sure to answer it for you.
Exactly. Exactly. We're all about answering questions here.
So we are going to get ready for our last full day of programming.
Sad but true.
And have a lot of fun at it. I got to go work on a costume for Billy for the pet parade.
All right, guys, that's all we have right now. Again, if you have any questions, any comments, any concerns, any tips, please leave them below. And there's also multiple other ways to get a hold of us.
Get a hold of us at our site at theroadsweroam.com. Click on the contact page, or you can also click the send a voicemail, and it's that little orange tab on the side of any of our pages on the site.
Mm-hmm.
You can also get a hold of us at Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, and Twitter. So we want to hear from you. Drop us a line. We'll talk to you later.
All right. Bye.